in London. Always knew I was gonna be something, but I still ain't seen none of this coming. Living life and enjoying this money, all this ice like it's new into something. Always knew I was gonna be something, but I still ain't seen none of this coming.
YouTube, back again with another video. Change of scenery, I'm back in my car. This is a different car. Car tour coming soon. Make sure you guys stay tuned for that. But today I'm just going to be teaching you guys how to tailor your pants. Hand sewn, no sewing machine needed. All right, let's get into it.
Hey y'all. Okay, so I get the question a lot about how much I charge. You guys, 9 times out of 10, I'm going in there, I'm discounting your return. I'm not here to hit you over the head. This is just something that helps me get through school. Two classes for the summer for me at UNC Charlotte is $5,000. I already have $27,000 in loans. Not that y'all care, but this helps me. That's just the classes alone. I still have to buy stuff for the classes and stuff like that. But I really appreciate y'all's business. The people who came to me last year, I love y'all. If y'all could spread the word, that would be great. If y'all got any other questions, let me know. I just know I get that question a lot. I am 100% affordable, you guys. Affordable. So, yes, hit me up. We can work something out.
Before you start, make sure you got these items, a pen or a marker. Some scissors, it doesn't matter what kind of scissors, as long as they cut. A needle, preferably one that's kind of thick. And some thread, the same color as your pants or close to it. This is my other pair of pants that I like the fit of. I'm going to be placing these pairs of pants on top of each other so I can trace the outline of the desired fit on top of the baggy ones. You guys are going to see what I'm talking about in a second. So right here, I'm just getting these pants up out the way. I'm gonna be folding these inside out. That way, I can actually see the inner seam. That's where I'm gonna be making my line at. So right now, I'm just trying to make sure that the seams are all straight. There's no wrinkles in the pants anywhere, any bubbles of any kind. I'm basically trying to weed out anything that will obstruct me from making the best product possible. So right now I'm grabbing my pants that I like the fit of, flipping them inside out. That way the seams can be as close as possible. And right here I'm going to be lining them up from the inside seam, the inner thigh basically. And that excess that you see on the right, I'm going to be tracing a line from the hip all the way down to the ankle. It doesn't have to be perfectly straight as long as it's consistent all the way down. So right now I'm going in and just filling in any areas that I miss with my pen. You can use a marker too, but I prefer a pen because it doesn't leave a harsh line. You can't see it through the pants, basically. As you can see, my line is crooked. Just know, when these things are done, it's gonna look crazy, crazy good, like you bought them from the store. So right now I'm just showing you guys another angle of the line. See, mine is not perfect, but watch. Keep watching the video, you're gonna see how they turned out. So right now I'm just grabbing my thread. Make sure you guys get some blue thread, or if you got some black jeans, get some black thread. Gray jeans, get gray thread. Make it make sense, you guys. So right now I'm just threading my needle. And that's why I said get a bigger needle, so it's easier to thread the needle with your thread, because it's kind of a pain to thread really, really small needles, and they break sometimes too if you don't have good quality ones. So right now I'm just trying to make sure that it's as long as the pants. And then I'm gonna make it a little more longer than the pants, that way I can tie a nice knot. All right, so right now I'm just rolling out the remaining thread, making sure that I got more thread than my pants so I can tie a nice knot on the end of my thread so that it doesn't just come through my pants. The knot has to be quite thick. Keep that in mind, you guys. You don't want a thin knot at the end, and I'm gonna show you guys how I tie my knots. So I'm gonna wrap it around my finger 4 or 5 times, and then I'm gonna get the needle and put it through the hole. Make sure you guys don't stab yourself. You're gonna put it through there all the way. You're gonna pull it all the way through, and then you're gonna tie it again 2 or 3 more times. And then you're gonna do the same thing, but make sure you put it in the same spot as you did it the first time. Make sure you guys watch this part again if you guys aren't sure. So I'm gonna pull it tight. You see how thick my knot is right there? That's not gonna come through my pants at all. Okay, so I'm showing you guys this right here kind of fast because it took me a long time. This is a very pivotal part in your pants, the way you start them off. it is very pivotal. So make sure you guys are taking your time and you're being really consistent and you're doing stitches. So I'm just going in and out, making sure everything is really close together and it's nice and consistent all the way around. All right, so this right here is what I like to call the running stitch. So basically, I just get the stitch and I just bob and weave. One, two, just the easiest way to sew. But mind you, if you're stitching your pants like this or anything like this, you have to make multiple passes. So I couldn't just go up this leg one time with that kind of stitch. I would have to do it at least two or three more times. See what I'm doing? I'm gonna show you guys from a different angle and it slowed down. This is just me doing the entire leg. It probably took me 2 minutes to do the entire leg. And then I went back and then it took me another 2 minutes. I did two passes total. All right, so this is a close-up angle on what is the technique on actually how to do it. It's not that hard. So make sure you guys are paying attention. Watch this clip two or three times so you guys know what you're doing. Don't stab yourself either. I've been doing this for a long time, so I know how to do it quite easily now. All right, so right here, this is a time lapse of me doing the other leg. I'm basically doing the same steps, repeating the same steps. Don't even think about it too hard. What you did to one side is the other side. Whoosh. All right, so this is the finished product. Just to show you guys, these are the same pants. I still have the tags on them. These are my Chelsea boots. Look at that. Showing you guys the seam I did. It's not perfect, but when these are on your legs, man, nobody gonna be able to tell. All right, make sure you guys like the video, share, subscribe. Peace. See you guys next time.